Good evening, friendos. It's time for a quest for semi-glorious Salt Android Cactus speedruns tonight. We've got three more to set baselines for Mega Weapons campaign. So let's go ahead and get started. First up, Shiitake. Okay. Probably still going to be the slowest one, as she is for normal campaign and campaign plus. But you know, that's to be expected. I'm really curious what her mega railgun is going to be. I'm hoping for some sort of ultra automatic weapon or something, but you know, whatever. All right, so let's get it going in 3, 2, 1. Go. Okay, let's see what we're dealing with here. It is kind of a automatic one. Dang, that's pretty sick. That is pretty sick, actually. Just have to try to make use of it in an actually effective manner. That's interesting. I would guess it's weaker than the normal railgun, because having an automatic railgun that's super powerful, like normal style power, would be kind of ridiculous. Like, kind of ridiculous. I wonder how this is gonna work for like mine cans and wasp cans and all that though. Because my goodness, we already have real shitty wasp handling without. Yeah, that is pretty weak, honestly, and we took a dumb down there, so go me. Go me. Hey, Valiant Cheese, how you doing? Good to see ya. Good to see ya. We're doing the best we can with our good old mega weapons. This is really the first time I've ever used mega weapons in Shiitake, so it's gonna be a bit of a learning experience, as it already is, but that's okay. I mean, that's why we're here. That's why we're here. Well, no, that's not true. We're here to go fast. We're here to go fast. And if that involves learning, I guess we'll just have to deal with it. Yeah. Bug in a really early build where you could enable and control the four characters on mouse and keyboard. I think I've managed to, maybe not. I think I remember running into that, maybe not recently, but some time ago. But I don't know that it was any fault of the game. I think my control setup was all fudgy that time. But that sounds absolutely hilarious. That sounds hilarious, and I can't imagine doing it with, like, four shiitakes or something. That would be just absolutely serious. Absolutely silly. Just too silly. Like, I'm all for silly shit every now and again, but that is just too silly. Like, how would you manage such power? Pretty nice. I am probably gonna miss the propeller mines once we get to zone 2, though. But we'll just have to make do, you know? Sometimes you can't have it all. And sometimes you can have it all. But you don't do good things with it. Oh shit, there's still a dude left. I thought that was all. It's absolutely silly having an automatic railgun. I kinda love it. Controlled bursts, I think, is the way to go. Short controlled bursts, or treat it like an automatic sniper rifle or something. Easy peasy. Alright, still kind of slow, but that's alright. That's alright. I mean, shiitake, you expect a little bit of slowness here. Yeah, that's definitely not as bulky powerful as the mines for doing single target. But, you know. It's something. It's something different. It's something different. Still as easy as ever. Alright, so we're looking at like a 645 zone 1. Not bad. Not terrible. Not great, necessarily. Alright, see, now having wasps and shit is gonna be a little bit super dumb, considering the very narrow area we're gonna be able to impact with this thing. Zone 2 will probably not be our best zone, considering how many Wasparinos we're dealing with. Just need to make sure we get a firepower going here. Small shift in balances mechanical behavior is enough to make a game feel fresh and new. Yeah, that's... you're very right. You're very right. I kind of regret not doing, mega campaign runs earlier, but... you know, when you run a game for... going on 4 years now... you gotta find some way to have your fun with it. Hive. Well, about what I would expect considering all the wasps. Not looking forward to Vespi with this though. My goodness, it's gonna be a pain in the butt. $30, that's a little bit better. $21, even better. And grab that firepower before it turned, but big ol' failure. Too bad.
Thank you.
47, sure. Sure. Okay, zone 2 isn't too terrible. First level obviously wasn't the greatest. Hoping they would pulse out again and give me a bit of a space to maneuver around. No such luck though.
Contact me.
wasn't as bad of a Vespi as I was expecting. Took that dumb down on Wasp 2 there. But if I hadn't taken any downs, I would have been surprised. Okay, seemed like a reasonable checkpoint. Good old casual ass plus there. Didn't even need to do the spin there. A lot of dancing there. Pretty good. Pretty good management there. Thank you. 230. Mm. Ooh, that's a little spicy. Yep, okay. Kind of expected. Okay. couple dumb downs there. Buck 49 though, still pretty good. Exactly. Was bad as always.
Initiating containment protocol. Establishing defense perimeter.
Pretty much of a pushover justice.
Thank you.
54, okay.
Firepower.
a pretty nice assembly. 227. Nice. Dookie. Oh, nice. I just waltz into that entire spread. That's the way to do it. Vespi wasn't too bad. Wasn't too bad. We took a couple silly downs on a couple of the wasp phases, but honestly, that was expected. 100% expected. But the non-ball phases were pretty good, actually. Surprisingly good, in fact. Wasps as a whole are still kind of a pain in Shiitake's rear end here, but not really a whole bunch you can do about that. Yeah, that's not gonna end well. It traipsed through that group of bugs way too much. Fuck. Like, ah, crap. Doggo's gonna grab me. That'll be the end of that. Oh, look at that, I was right. Sure. Remembered the mines that time. Split name pays off. Oh, jeez. Almost forgot him that time, though. Thirteen repeater, wow. Okie dokie. Oh good, the easiest boss. Actually this should be a little bit easier since we don't have to get super up in his grill with the mines. Gonna go at any distance, honestly. That was fun. That's a touch easier than trying to get all up in there, you know? Nice! Come on, really? Couldn't quite pull that one out. Womp. Fuck you, Venom. Dang. Almost clean. Almost real clean there. Accelerate. Oh, come on. Even heard the swap noise there. Pretty good though, pretty good. 201, almost a sub 2. It's pretty impressive. Well, it would have been. It would have been pretty impressive. No, this is a normal campaign, not campaign plus. Haven't quite gotten to that just yet. That's why we're blazing the trail so quickly through a lot of these. Normal campaign, the machine gun's on the bottom. In campaign plus, they shift it over to the right. It screws up muscle memory. Yep, you had him flipped then. scared there. Shut down. Nice. Wow. That's pretty good convection. Sub 3 and casual S plus. Sure. Sure, sure, sure. Sure, sure, sure. My goodness. There. Try to keep her away from that one. Oh! Dang it. That's right. It's just good old fashioned railgun slug up the head. Licorice has her mega weapons equipped now. That would be interesting. Be an interesting go of things.
You have no idea.
Nope. F you. Eh? Eh? You want to dance around a little bit? Okay. Okay. Just do it. Be an idiot like that? That's fine. I ain't gonna stop you. There we go. Very clean Licorice fight. Nice casual S plus Licorice too, 209. Very good. Well, I don't think we'll manage a sub 50 here, but it's gonna be close. It's gonna be a little close. If we end up doing better than our coral run, that's gonna be a little embarrassing, huh? Still pulled it out. Ooh, yeah, this is gonna be real close to a 50. Nice flat 50. But not quite. Thank you.
Whoop! Aw, oh, nuts.
Nice. Okay. Pretty good. Be a 50-30 and a little bit of change, perhaps? Yeah, 50-30-98. Not bad. Not bad. These readings make no sense. For the safety of everyone on board, we should... Yes, yes, thank you, Aubergine. Always looking out for our safety. What a gal. Alright. Cool. Sub 50 is definitely possible, considering how trash I was at some of those levels. Alright. Very good. Next up will be the nut. Let's get some nut splits opened up here. Doot 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 doot. Get some mega magma going on. Oops, wait. There we go. He stayed at a place called the Nut over the New Year when bushwalking hung out with some wild penguins. That sounds fucking rad. Back in the town where I grew up, we have a ski hill called the Nut Hill. I'm pretty sure they named it before that became common parlance for, you know. Now I just think back to it and I just laugh. It was funny. Because it's funny and my sense of humor is decidedly lowbrow. Alright! Peanut! With her Mega Magma. Mega Magma. Let's go in 3, 2, 1! Go. That doesn't seem to be used so commonly over here. And, you know, it's... I wouldn't even say it's common here either. It's just like one of those weird internet things. Alright, let's see what we got. Holy heck, that's one heck of a nut. Wow. You need to nut something out. Okay, I can see that happening, yeah. My goodness, well, Mega Magma responsibly, I guess. Holy heck. Jeez. Wow. Alright, well. It's a damn fine AoE, tell you what. Dang, that felt like a real quick 1-1 here. 58 seconds, holy shit. Alright, okay, that's a real good start. Oh, okay, so that's one and done. There's no flow control on that one. Jeez, this is so good. Yeah, that's true. You get no zoom 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 with the drill, which is unfortunate because that's always really fun, but... I mean, you can't have it all. You gotta give something if you want to get something. Oh man, that's super good. There we go. Whew. That's fun. Buck 15, not bad. Downhill slalom drill game. There we go. They can stick that in Cactus 2. The Cactus inning. Yeah. electric cactusaloo. They can make a downhill drill slalom a minigame for Peanut. That'd be fun. Oh, I guess there is flow control. I can swap back before using it all. I guess that makes a lot of sense. But who wouldn't want to just use it all right away? I mean, it's so fucking cool. Liquid hot magma. Skiradai did have a downhill. It had a downhill slalom, I think? I could never figure out how to do it. I was always super trash at that one. The snowboard halfpipe was my favorite on that particular game. Got kind of good at it. Yeah, there was also the downhill inner tube thing too. That's true. That one was always kind of weird. They had the downhill skiing, they had the inner tube thing, snowboard half pipe, the snowball fight thing, the high jump, and there's one more that I'm missing. There were six things. Oh no, maybe there was five and then you could chain them all together in a tournament event or something. Yeah, the ski jump. Thank you. Not the high jump. I think the track and field. Fried embryo, holy crap. Mixed up. Dang, that's awesome. Snowball blast, downhill blitz, acro aerials, inner tube thrash, and snowboard halfpipe. Yeah, there you go. That is definitely the oopsie. That is definitely the things. 37 is a lot better. What did I have, like a 220 or something with Shiitake? It's kind of silly. And again, I didn't have the wasp melting power of a Mega Magma here. See you later, Cheese. Thanks for stopping by. Good luck with your work stuffs. More poorly there. Well, buck 35, I guess, wasn't too bad. That was a pretty good oxygen. Buck 05, heck yeah. Process. Buck 19? Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Get melted. Love it. Pretty good recipe. Just melted. 1 minute flat. Incredible. Until we get to the final segment. Oh, come on, really? Still pretty solid. Anything sub 2 from here on out, probably good enough. Good enough for who it's for. Two, almost a flat 2 transit.
Fire power.
25 heat. Holy crap. Revolution. Fuck 50. Holy crap. Wow.
Initiating containment protocol.
Oh, dang it. Stepped a little bit too close.
Establishing defense perimeter.
There. That's right. Just stand up and nut again. It's still a sub one despite that disgusting display.
I
Very clean slash messy assembly. 205, alright. Relay?
Eh.
About average. Probably kind of an average focus as well. Well, buck 54 is pretty good.
Accelerate.
Oh, damn it. It's helpful here since most of the floor falls away before the magma can get onto it. Kind of a bad repeater. 222, pretty effective. Oh, damn it. With the string of death there. Pretty average venom.
Fire power.
15 cent douche. Fixed up. 56, heck yeah. In control. 219, sure. Is that down at the end count? It doesn't, for scoring reasons. It's a clean 5 hundo. Oh, excuse me, bastard. Pretty clean. 222. Not as clean as our shiitake one, but definitely pretty clean. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Won't be a sub 45. Pretty good. Pretty good regardless. Ah. Eat that one in the face. Sure, why not? Phew, that's pretty good. 45-22, huh? Alright. Okay. That might be our best one to date. Although I think our obby run was pretty good too. That might have been a high 45. Alright. Well, we'll hold on to that one for dang sure. We've got one more baseline to set, but I don't know if I want to do it tonight. How about we just cool down with the daily then? Let's just cool down with the daily with, you know what? Let's do a lemon daily. Why not? Why not? Why not? Why not? That's a silly notion, but we're gonna do it anyways. Alright, because I can't do it with that. Mega weapons turned on. Yes. We're gonna regret this. We're gonna regret this, but we're gonna do it anyways. Whatever, it's fine. Dark egg, huh? Interesting. Very interesting. Oops, I didn't want to accelerate. Tried to let it widen out and dance through, but wasn't gonna work that way today. There.
Accelerate. Battery here. Fire
Ow! Yikes. Perhaps not a good day for Lemon.
Alright, who's next?
Perhaps not a good day for Lemon. My goodness. Didn't help that I took, what, 3 downs there? Yeah. Blech. Blech. Blech, blech, blech. Well, alright. That'll do it for tonight. We'll kick out a touch early.
We'll kick out a touch early and leave the last baseline for Licorice for next week.
Alright, that'll do it for tonight. Next stream will be tomorrow night, 7 p.m. CST. We'll be back on Children of Morta. Alright, thanks for watching, everybody. And we'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.